Hello everyone, the title of today's lecture is Numerical on Work Transfer. Problem number 1, a system composed of 3 kg of substance which expands from an initial pressure of 500 kPa and a volume of 0.22 m³ to a final pressure 100 kPa in a process in which pressure and volume are related by PV raised to 1.2 is equal to constant. Find the work transfer for this process. So given process is polytrophic expansion process. We have to find out the work transfer. The polytrophic expansion process is represented on the PV plane like this, the expansion process 1 to 2. Now given that the P1 and V1 is given. Now P2 is also given, that is in kilopascal. The relation, that is polytrophic expansion PV raised to 1.2 is equal to constant, is given. So N is equal to 1.2. The formula for work transfer is equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon 1 minus N. Now the V2 is unknown, so V2 can be find out by using this correlation, where N is equal to 1.2 and P1 and P2 are kept in the consistent unit, that is 5 and 1. That is 500 by 100 kilonewton per meter square. So we got the values of volume V2 is equal to 0.845 meter cube. The expression for work transfer is equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon 1 minus N. Here the pressure is given in 100 kilonewton per meter square. So that is converted into newton per meter square by multiplying 10 to the power 2, that is 100. So that is here pressure P1 is P2 is 100 and P1 is 500. So that's multiplying by 100, that is taken common here. So we got the values, that is 127.5, since the value, the expression, the unit of P is in kilo newton per meter square. So that's why we got the unit of work transfer is equal to 127.5 kilojoules. Problem number 2, a fluid is confined in a cylinder by a spring loaded frictionless piston so that the pressure in the fluid is a linear function of the volume P is equal to a plus bv, where P in kilopascal and V in cubic meter. If the fluid changes from an initial state of 170 kilopascal 0.03 meter cube to a final state of 400 kilopascal 0.06 meter cube with no work other than that done on the piston, find the direction and magnitude of the work transfer. So the given data is P1, V1 is given. The pressure volume at state 1 is given. Similarly, pressure and volume at state 2 is also given. And the relation between pressure and volume is also given. So by keeping the values of pressure and volume in this expression, that is, we can find out the values of constant A and B. So by solving these two equations, we got the values, that is, A is equal to this minus 60 and B is equal to 7667. As in the given units. Now the work transfer, that is formula for this, is in basic formula for work transfer is equal to integration of PdV, where P is given in terms of V and the constant A and B. By keeping the values of P in this expression and doing the integration, we got this expression final and put the values of volume in meter cube, and we'll get the final values of work transfer 8.55 kilo joules. Since the positive since the value is positive, the work is done by the system and the magnitude is being 8.55 because of this positive sign of the work transfer. Now problem number 3, a gas is compressed hyperbolically from a pressure and volume of 100 kN per meter square and 0.056 meter cube respectively to a volume of 0.007 meter cube. Determine the final pressure and the work done on the gas. So the given data is that the process is hyperbolic compression process, or that is nothing but the isothermal process. So here P1, V1 values are given, V2 is given, P2 we have to find out. So by using this relation for the polytrophic compression, for isothermal compression process, that is hyperbolic process, this relation is valid or applicable. P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. From this, we can find out the values of P2, that comes 800 kN per meter square. Now, the formula for work transfer for isothermal process is PV ln R, where R is the compression ratio, that is V2 by V1. By keeping the values of pressure in that 100 multiplied by 10 to the power 3, so that comes the basic unit, that is in 100, that pressure of this is a kilonewton per meter square P1. So that is given. So kilonewton is converted into newton per meter square by multiplying, that is 10 to the power 3. And by keeping this ln means log to the base e, so by keeping these values we got this value, that is minus 11.64 kilojoules. Okay, so the work done on the gas is 11.64 kilojoules, since the negative value represents the work is done on the gas. Problem number 4. 0.014 meter cube gas at a pressure of 2070 kilonewton per meter square expands to a pressure of 207 kilonewton per meter square according to the law PV^1.35 is equal to constant. Determine the work done by the gas during the expansion. So the process is polytrophic expansion process, and the work done during the polytrophic expansion is given by this formula, P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon N minus 1. In this problem, V2 is unknown. So by using this relation, P1 V1 raised to N is equal to P2 V2 raised to N, we can find out the V2, and that V2 value comes 0.077 meter cube. Here important thing that the pressure unit should be same, and volume should, whatever the unit of V1, the same unit is applicable for V2. So we have to take care of the units while solving the problems, and the formula is important. The problem number 4, okay, that a solution is still not completed. So work done is equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon N minus 1. So work done is equal to, by keeping the values, so 2070, that was in kilonewton per meter square, by multiplying 10 to the power 3, that is in newton per meter square. So basic unit of work done, that will be in joules, and by converting, that is in the, by keeping these all these values, we got the values of work done is 37.3 kilojoules. So again, the positive value represent, that is the work is done by the system on the surrounding. Problem number 5. Determine the power transmitted through the shaft of a car when the torque applied is 200 newton meter and the shaft rotates at a rate of 4000 revolutions per minute. Now the speed is given in, that is in RPM 4000, and torque is given 200 newton meter. So the formula for shaft power is equal to 2πnt, where 2π is constant, n is RPM. So that is, we have to convert in RPS by dividing by 60 seconds, that is by 60, and by dividing 10 to the power 3, so we got the values of power, shaft power is equal to 83.8 kilowatt, that is equal to, or that is also equal to 112 HP. So 1 HP is equal to 0.746 kilowatt. So by using that correlation, we can convert that kilowatt into HP. Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you.